at 2.4 volt input, our calculated value was 10.837. The physical value 2.409, 10.84. I applied 1.00 volt, the same gain which we calculated, the same gain is here, 4.51.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel.
In video number 1172, I discussed operational amplifier. In video number 1172A, I discussed non-inverting operational amplifier using dual power supplies. Why we need two power supplies, plus 12 volt, minus 12 volt, or any plus minus power supplies? When we have bipolar signal, any signal that is swinging in positive direction and then in negative direction, sine wave, square wave, sawtooth wave, whatsoever, but its amplitude is increasing or decreasing in both directions, 0 to up, 0 to down. That time we use operational amplifier. If we need in phase output, that time we use non-inverting configuration to take output. It will amplify this signal. Low amplitude signal, amplified signal with high amplitude. Today we will discuss single supply operational amplifier. When any sensor provides output from 0 to upside increasing like this at a specific voltage level, and we want to amplify it and we need in phase output, that time non-inverting amplifier using single supply, because its amplitude is increasing in one direction. When we have bipolar signal, that time we need dual power supplies. Let's suppose I have 12 volt power supply from 0 to 12. This signal will increase as input signal. If it is linear, it will linear. Any shape here will be transferred in the output with amplified level. We are using LM324. This is pin out of LM324 IC. Pin number 4 is VCC. Pin 11 is ground. That is in that condition when we are using single supply. Maximum 32 volt can be applied. From lower voltage 3 volt to 32 volt, we can use any available power supply. If we are using dual power supplies, that time maximum plus minus 16 volt. That is also 32 volt level. In LM324, there are 4 segments, 4 channels, 4 independent operational amplifiers. Power supply is common for all sections, but each section has its own input, own output. Pin 1 output for first channel, pin 2 is inverting input, pin 3 is non-inverting input. It is one channel. Second channel, pin 5, non-inverting, that is plus sign, negative inverting sign. Pin 7 output, same here. When we apply supply voltage here at VCC pin, that time when it will switch from zero side, it will provide few millivolt offset, but when we take positive output, at that time it will deduct approximately 1 volt, 1.4 volt from the output. Pin number 4, positive VCC. Pin number 11, ground are negative supply. Positive sign, negative sign. These are non-inverting inputs and inverting inputs. This is output. In this case, I will connect power here. Negative and positive 12 volts. This is negative side, so we will give polarity here. Pin 4 positive, positive supply will here, and pin 11 is negative supply, plus 12 volts. This line ground. Now I am using this section, this one. I am taking output from pin number 7. We will provide non-inverting input at pin number 5. Pin number 6 is inverting input. To take a useful function from any operational amplifier, op-amp, we need feedback network. Feedback network is connected between inverting input and this point. It is called R1, and this is called feedback resistance. And we will inject any signal here. Let's suppose we will make a signal here, 20k, 5k potentiometer to take variable output, and we will connect this end to ground. Let's calculate this signal. If I connect 20k resistor here and one potentiometer, this end ground, 5k and here 12 volt. Let's check available supply. I have fixed voltage power supply, 12.38 volt. Available supply is 12.38. If I connect 20k resistor, 10k 2 resistors in series, for a good calculation we will use the exact value, 19.7, and the potentiometer value 4.77k. 19.7 4.77k. What are the output voltage? V in, let's suppose this is R1 divided by RT. We have 12.38 volts divided with 4.77 plus 19.7. Maximum output voltage until here between ground and this will vary from 0 volt to 2.414 volt. This is our input range. If we will use this potentiometer with ground, let's connect it. I will connect this resistor and to positive, this point to ground, at extreme counterclockwise position of this knob there are 0 volt. When I will rotate it full clockwise position, it is 2.4 volt, as we calculated here, 2.4 volt. input voltage maximum 2.4 volt. This may be from any sensor or from any circuit. Maximum 12.3 volt, that is supply voltage. 12.38 minus 1.4 volt, 10.98. We will consider 11 volt. 11 volt is the extreme limit that can be provided in the output when full signal is applied here. Its required gain V out divided by V in. 11 divided by 2.4, we need gain of 4.58. This is our required gain. To set gain, we need this feedback resistor value. We will assume R1 10k, gain A, that is 4.58, 1 plus RF divided by R1, 4.58 is equal to 1 plus RF we need. R1 is 10 kilo ohms. 4.58 minus 1 multiplied by 10, 35.8 kilo ohm. 35.8 k. This is calculated value. If you cannot find the same value, we can use the closer value, that is 33k. It is 32.7 plus 1k to make 35.8 kilo ohms. I will use 33k and two 1k resistors in series. Output pin, pin number 7 and pin number 6, and one resistor between pin number 6 and ground, that is 10 kilo ohms resistor. Now these are available components. This resistor is now the physical value 9.87. 9.87, and the upside feedback resistor is 34.7k. Okay, we will use this one. This 10k resistor will be connected between pin number 6 and ground. This is ground pin, and this end will reach to pin number 6, and feedback resistor between output pin and pin number 6, that is inverting input. This negative feedback is necessary to control the gain. Now let's calculate gain. This was the required gain, and now the gain value, 1 plus RF is 34.7 divided by 9.87. Our practical gain is now 4.515. 4.515. That means if we will provide 2.4 volt at input and we have gain 4.1, 2.4, 10.837. When we have peak signal at input, the peak output must be 10.837. Let's check it now. Now our circuit is ready. DC voltage. This is common. Common at common of both multimeters. We calculated gain 4.15. If I will apply 100 millivolt signal here, multiply with this one, approximately similar value is here. Point 0.2, multiply with this, the same value. Point 0.5, multiply with this figure, output is here. Let's inject 1 volt. I applied 1.00 volt, the same gain which we calculated, the same gain is here, 4.51. it is 1.001, exactly the same calculated gain. Let's inject 2 volt. At 2 volt, 2 multiply with this figure, the same output voltage. At 2.4 volt input, our calculated value was 10.837. The physical value 2.409, 10.84 output. So in this way, we can plot any input signal at the output. I hope this video is informative for you. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.